plan if they cannot land Kevin Durant. Mark Stein reporting the Knicks could give a considerable one-year offer to Boogie Cousins. Now, remember, he only played 30 regular season games last season at Achilles, but he did average over 16 points. Shannon, where would you rank Boogie among the available free agents right
now? Well, he's down. He's out of the top 10, Skip. I don't see him as a top 10 free agent, looking at the list. But it makes sense for the Knicks, Skip, if they swing and miss on all the big-time free agents. Mm-hmm. I don't see someone giving him more than a one-year deal, considering his injury history. Achilles injury coming off that. Coming off the quad injury and given his age. So I can see them giving him a one-year, $10 million, $15, maybe even $20 million deal, Skip, because remember, you miss out on KD, you miss out on Kawhi, you miss out on Kyrie, Kemba, Jimmy. What other options do you have? Mm. And you just hope he can resurrect. Now, he was never above-the-rim player, but he has zero lift now, Skip. Mm. Those injuries have robbed him of what little lift that he did have. Can he get that back? I don't know, given his age and this injury history. But I don't see someone, even after this year, committing more than 2 years. You don't want to get stuck 2 years in a deal and paying him $25, $30 million with his injury history. I don't see it happening. But it makes sense for the Knicks, considering they're probably going to swing and miss on all the free agents.
Mm. I am a DeMarcus Cousins fan, and I still think he has big game left. And I got you. He didn't look quite the same last year, but I think he'll look stronger and stronger as next year progresses. I agree with you. Long term, it's a little scary. But next 2 years, I think he's going to be a dominating inside presence.
Okay.
And I know it didn't work out with Anthony in New Orleans, but...
Man. It was working out, Skip. I mean, they were playing well until he went down.
I got it. But it wasn't, it didn't quite pair up the way thought it might, because they were such close friends. They just play too much the same way. Mm-hmm. They're too close to the same player. But this guy, boy, you're saying not even top 10? I'm going to remind you, since his rookie year, he's the only player in the NBA to average 20 and 10, and that's with a minimum of at least 550 games.
Right.
But he's going to give you 20 and 10 when he's right.
Right.
He's got touch. He's got girth and mass. And he can – we saw flashes in the final.
Yeah.
Of he just took the game over because he's got firepower in him. Does he always play as hard as you would – no, he doesn't always play as hard. It's kind of Zion-like, except Zion just plays hard every dribble of every possession.
But you remember what he liked when he was on a young team and he was a dominating voice in there in Sacramento.
Yep.
My thing is, Skip, is all the other free agents, with the exception of KD, has a clean bill of health. He's the only one that's coming with those questionable. He's not Kemba. He's not Kyrie. He's not Kawhi, Jimmy Butler. I'm taking Vucevic. Vucevic was an all-star, and he has no injury history. Mm. So that's why I got him ranked where he's ranked, Skip. I don't think he's a top 10 of the available free agents. Mm. Can he get back? Now, if he was 100% healthy, he's a top 5 free agent. Mm-hmm. But he's not. Mm.
Great stuff, gentlemen. Looming questions that will soon be answered in free agency.
Yes.
And still to come this morning, we're going to answer the question, is LeBron about to bring one of his buddies to L.A.?
Which buddy?
We'll discuss that.
I might be coming.
Yeah.